We want to find the following products. Notice in the first example we have a monomial times a binomial times a binomial. Now we can't do this all in one step. We're going to work our way from left to right, so we'll start by distributing the 3x here and here. It would be incorrect to distribute the 3x into the second binomial. That would be equivalent to, for example, if we had the product of 2 times 3 times 4, you wouldn't multiply the 2 and the 3 and the 2 and the 4. You'd work your way from left to right. So it's the same idea. So 3x times x would be 3x squared. And then 3x times 1 would be 3x. Then we're going to multiply this product by x minus 3. And this will give us our final product. So now we can FOIL this, or think of double distribution, meaning we'll distribute the 3x squared into the second binomial, and then distribute the 3x into the second binomial. So we'll have a total of 4 products. So first we have 3x squared times x, that'll be 3x to the third. And then we have 3x squared times a negative 3, that'll be minus 9x squared. Then we have 3x times x, that'll be plus 3x squared. And the last product will be 3x times negative 3, which would be minus 9x. Notice how we do have two x squared terms here in the middle, which we can combine.
Simplifying, we have 3x cubed.
And then for negative 9x squared plus 3x squared, that would be negative 6x squared, or minus 6x squared. Minus 9x. For the second example, we have a binomial times a trinomial. So to multiply here, we'll first distribute the y into the second polynomial here, here, and here, and then we'll distribute a negative 2, 1, 2, 3 times. Notice how we have a total of 6 products. So we'll first have y times y squared, that's y cubed. Then we'll have y times 2y, that'll be plus 2y squared. Then we'll have y times 4, that's plus 4y. And now we'll distribute the negative 2, so negative 2 times y squared, we'll have minus 2y squared. Then negative 2 times positive 2y, that's minus 4y. And then we have a negative 2 times a positive 4, that's minus 8. And now we'll add like terms. Notice how we have 2y squared terms and 2y terms. So we'd have y cubed, and then notice how the y squared terms are opposites. We have positive 2y squared minus 2y squared, that's 0. And the y terms are also opposites. We have positive 4y minus 4y, that's 0. So we're left with y cubed minus 8.